Hello again. I hope you all had a good start into 2021 and thanks for clicking on my video. In my last video, I introduced the inventory system and the interaction system. Today's devlog is gonna expand on that. Item tooltips now show more information about the item. Like when they are equippable, you can see the slot and armor type of the item, as well as the attribute boni you get from equipping them. Last time I also mentioned not being able to split stacks in your inventory. This has also been added and you can take any amount of items out of an existing item stack by pressing shift and left clicking. One of the bigger changes of this video is the ability for me to put spells on items. You can see that in action here. I've added the execute spell, which is also in my hotbar, to this item. And it works just like the spell itself. This way it's very easy for me to create consumables like potions and food items. Speaking of which, I've also added a few icons for bags and created this test potion, which restores health on use and consumes the item in the process. I have also expanded the NPC interactions a bit by adding the possibility of a vendor option. If the NPC is a vendor and already has a text menu attached to them, it will add a vendor option on the bottom of the list. If there isn't already a text option, the vendor menu will just pop straight up. Items that can be bought can be set up so that the vendor only has a limited amount of them. I know the UI isn't really that readable yet, but you can see here on the infinite small health potion that there's a little one in the top right corner of the icon. If I buy this, I cannot buy more of that item as the vendor is out of stock. The UI doesn't update yet, but if I close it and reopen the vendor menu, you can see that this item is gone. In the future there will be a timer on the refreshment of the items, or maybe even randomized cells, but right now the vendor only refreshes his offers after respawning. The newest and for this video probably biggest addition is actually a very important one. Loot. In the last video, I talked a bit about how to choose a random option for the interaction system based on a given weight. This also applies to loot, although the way an item is chosen sounds more complicated than it actually is. In the database, every loot table is defined with a minimum and maximum number of rolls, which represent the amount of times an item has to be chosen. For each of those rolls, one of the predefined loot pools gets chosen based on its weight, as I discussed in the last video. The chosen loot pool then chooses again based on an item weight and randomizes its amount also based on a preset value. A loot pool may also have multiple rolls, which means if the loot table rolls once, a loot pool may choose two items anyway since it's set to roll twice. This allows me to attach different loot pools to multiple loot tables without having duplicate data. In the future, I also want to implement the conditional system I have in place for items, vendors and spells into this, to allow for example quest-specific loot only to drop when the quest is active. Currently, loot is not only applicable to creatures, but also to items. The loot on the items also gets saved to the database to ensure consistency. I do not want players to reroll their loot every time they open a container. The last thing I want to talk about today, which is also item related, is prefab attachments for equipment. Technically it was already in for things like hair and facial hair meshes, but I also made it possible for items to spawn prefabs on the attachment point, which is associated with the item's slot. This means I can equip this debug stick here either on the main or offhand, and the prefab will show up on the right side. Obviously the rotations are all wrong right now, and since this is bad to see, I also created this helmet. Anyway, The next devlog is probably going to take some more time as usual, as I have decided to do some upgrades on older code as well as other stuff that I will talk about next time. Have a good time, see ya!